Welcome to the video news of the week. The Beecher Falls Volunteer Fire Department responded to a structure fire on Canaan Hill in Canaan, Vermont at about 8 o'clock on Wednesday evening. The camp owned by Dan Wade was fully engulfed in a complete loss. Assisting on the scene were Pittsburgh Fire Department personnel and the 45th Parallel EMS. Roads to the burn were difficult to navigate due to rain and spring thaw. No injuries were reported as a result of the fire. Residents in the town of Colebrook gathered for the annual town meeting on Tuesday night. Selectmen and town officials updated residents on plans for the coming year. All articles were passed unanimously, with some discussion being raised on Article 19. The article in question focused on long-term plans for a potential district heating network in Colebrook. Concerns were raised over any potential increase in tax rates, which the board stated they hoped would not be an issue. At the close of the meeting, former selectman Roland Cotnor announced the recipient of this year's Citizen of the Year Award, which went to State Representative for District 1 Larry Rappaport. A breakfast was hosted for town business people and elected officials at the Colebrook Country Club last Friday, March 8th. New Hampshire State Senator Jeff Woodburn was present to discuss his work on a bill which would authorize licensing for a gaming facility in the state. He made it specifically clear that his goal was to push revenues from the facility northward for economic development.
It's a single license at a price tag of $80 million, a high-end $450 million construction requirement. And, you know, with all those dynamics, it's going to be where the people are. It's going to be in southern New Hampshire. 10% of the net machine revenue, tax revenue, and they say net, that's you pay out the winnings first, and then what's left over. 10% of that will flow back to the North Country for economic development purposes. So, you know, I wanted the decision made here in the North Country and to create a three-person North Country board appointed by the governor.
I want to make sure that there's going to be a representative of the North Country on that team. Is that something you folks have talked about?
All three.
State Representative Larry Rappaport, who was present at the meeting, noted that he would be behind the bill if his constituents were in support of the idea.
I think it's more important that I hear from people in the district. If you want me to support this, if you want me to support gambling, I will. If you don't, then tell me that as well. I'll do what the majority asks.
Stratford School held an induction ceremony for its chapter of the National Junior Honor Society. Four new students joined the current member in the event, which was held last Thursday evening.
We are here to honor students who display outstanding qualities, scholarship, leadership, character, service, and citizenship.
Being inducted into the National Junior Honor Society is a privilege to those students who meet high standards, both in school and in their community.
The incoming inductees spoke on the qualities that define a member of the Junior Honor Society and were sworn into the organization.
I pledge myself to uphold the high purposes of the National Junior Honor Society.
The high purposes of the National Junior Honor Society.
Last Saturday, lifetime Colebrook resident Pauline Lemieux celebrated her 80th birthday. An open house was held at the Trinity United Methodist Church, where many came out to visit with and congratulate Pauline. She is the owner of Lemieux's Garage in downtown Colebrook. The evening of March 8th, the Bulwer Community Center was filled with Irish music for the annual Irish Night, hosted by the Eaton Corner Museum. The night began at 7 p.m., with over 150 people in attendance for the musical evening. Funds raised by the event go towards the upkeep of the museum.
Yeah.
Saturday night was the last of three Cabin Fever concerts in the historic Guildhall in Guildhall, Vermont. The night began with a series of local and regional open mic performers.
So don't you try to change her style. Might not be it all worthwhile. Well, she don't need no changing or no crazy rearranging. She's just trying to maintain her style. But I want you to know that's what you walked out on me. I'm so lonesome every day.
The feature performance that night was provided by Carrie Smith, Tim Berry, Lee Baker, and Russell Beck, who performed a range of country tunes.
Hey, Porter, would you tell me the time? How much longer will it be like Ross at Mason Dixon line? At daylight, would you tell that engineer to slow it down? Or better still, just stop the train, because I want to look around. I'm in the front seat, and I turn on the radio. Now that old song's coming out of them speakers, shall that country go? Then I noticed the stranger was ghost-like pale when he asked me for a light. And I knew there was something strange about this ride.
Wednesday night saw the close of another Winter Warmers concert series for the season. The show, sponsored by the Great Northwoods Committee for the Arts, was a night of old-timey and Celtic music. The night began with the Islay Miss Cayley and was followed by music provided by the Fireside Fiddlers.
The Colebrook Chronicle Video News of the Week is sponsored by the Upper Connecticut Valley Hospital in Colebrook. Visit their website at ucvh.org. Compassionate healthcare close to home. LaPerle's IGA of Colebrook. Great deals and instant coupons can be found on their website at laperlesiga.com. Colebrook Plumbing and Heating in Colebrook. Why heat with oil when you can heat economically with wood? Come see our whole house wood boiler solutions currently on sale. Murphy's Steakhouse at Bear Tree in Pittsburgh. Enjoy casual fine dining, a cozy atmosphere, and wonderful food. Try the chef's table on Sunday evenings. And by Woodsville Guaranty Savings Bank. Friendly local people, friendly local bank. And open 7 days a week inside Lancaster Shaw's. Friday, expect partly cloudy skies with a high of 35 degrees. Saturday temps drop a bit with a high of 31. And Sunday closes out the last weekend of winter with a high of 30 and a low of 10 degrees. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.